Now we'll look at two examples of determining derivative function values given two basic functions. First we have if f of x equals 2x minus 3, then f prime of 3 is equal to what value? So before we determine f prime of 3, we need to find our derivative function. So if f of x equals 2x minus 3, then f prime of x is going to be equal to 2 times the derivative of x. Well, the derivative of x is always equal to 1, so that'll just give us 2 times 1, or 2, minus the derivative of 3. The derivative of any constant is always 0, which means our derivative function is the constant function f prime of x equals 2. And notice how this derivative function value is not affected by x. Therefore, f prime of 3 is going to be equal to positive 2. The value of the derivative function at a given value of x gives us the slope of the tangent line at that location. So let's take a look at what's happening graphically. If we graph the original function f of x equals 2x minus 3, we have this line here that has a y-intercept of negative 3 and a slope of positive 2. From here we can go up 2 and right 1. Now if we look at the point on the function when x is equal to 3, we'd be at this point here. And if we try to sketch a tangent line to our graph at this point, we can see our tangent line passing through this point would be the same line as the original function, and therefore the slope of the tangent line would be the same slope as the original function, which we know is 2. This is why any point on this line, the derivative function value would always be positive 2. Now let's take a look at our second example. If g of x equals the constant 7, then g prime of negative 2 is equal to what value? So again, we'll first find our derivative function. So if g of x equals 7, g prime of x is always going to be equal to 0. Remember, the derivative of a constant is always 0. And again, this derivative function value is not affected by x. Therefore, g prime of negative 2 is also equal to 0. So this is telling us that if we try to sketch a tangent line to our constant function at x equals negative 2, the tangent line will have a slope of 0. Let's look at this graphically as well. Here's a graph of g of x equals 7. It's this horizontal line passing through 7 on the y-axis. Here's the point on the function when x equals negative 2. Remember, the slope of any tangent line is equal to 0. And if we try to sketch a tangent line to a horizontal line at this point here, it's going to be the same horizontal line, and therefore the slope is equal to 0. And this would be the case for any point that we selected on this horizontal line. And that's why the derivative function for a horizontal line is always equal to 0. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.